Hi children, welcome you all to the session. Today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter 3. What is the chapter name? Operation on whole numbers. So in this chapter we are going to do what are the operation using the whole numbers. We are going to do that. Okay, you can take page number 29 in your textbook children. Okay, you can find questions here. See, get set go questions. What is the first question which is given in Phillips's word? The answer of a addition sum is called dash. So after adding, what you will say that answer? You can think and say me. The answer of an addition sum is called the dash. So if I add these two values, you will get one answer, right? So what you will say that? That is our question. Okay, here 143 plus 171. Just we are going to add these two. So after adding 143, so I will start from here. Second number, I should start from here. 171. So 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 7, 11. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. So the answer which I am getting is called sum. Okay, did you understand? So the answer of this addition will be the sum. Understood? So what is the answer for the first question is? Sum. You can write S-U-M. Second question. What is the second question? While writing large numbers, we write them in dash column under a dash chart. Okay, they're asking while writing large numbers, big numbers you will add, no? So how you will write? You will write in vertical columns only, no? Columns will be what? It is vertical. Rows only, it is horizontal. So dash column means it is vertical column. You can write it. What is the spelling for vertical? V-E-R-T-I-C-A-L. Okay, V-E-R-T-I-C-A-L. Vertical columns under a dash chart. A dash chart, now what chart you will write there? It is a place value chart. Ones, tens, hundreds, like that you will write the number, right? So under a place value chart. What is the spelling for place value? P-L-A-C-E-V-A-L-U-E. Okay, place value chart. So second one answer is, for first dash you will write vertical columns, second dash you will write place value chart. What is the third question? The numbers to be added are called dash. Okay, the numbers to be added are called dash is your third question. Okay, 144 is added with 179. So this number and this numbers, the numbers to be added. So this number and 143 and 179 is called as addends. What is called, what it is called as? It is, these two numbers are called as addends. You can write this in your book itself, okay? A-D-D-E-N-D-S, addends. So third question answer is addends. Next is your fourth question. What is the fourth question? The numbers to be subtracted are called dash. Okay, the numbers to be subtracted. In previous question, the numbers to be added. Added na addends. Okay, subtracted na subtrahends. Okay, subtracted means what? Added means, I told you, addends. So subtracted means subtrahends. S-U-B-T-R-A. H-E-N-D-S, okay? S-U-B-T-R-A-H-E-N-D-S. So, did you got the fourth question answer? Yes. Fifth question. The number from which other number is to be subtracted is called dash. Okay. Two numbers will be there, okay? First, you will write one number. Second, you will write another number, right? So, you will actually subtract the second number from the first number, right? So, what is that second number is? It is called as minuend. What is called as minuend? M-I-N-U-E-N-D. What? M-I-N-U-E-N-D. Okay. Sixth question. Answer of a subtraction sum is called. Answer of addition sum is called what? Sum. Answer of a subtraction sum is what? Difference. Okay. Answer which we are getting for addition is called sum. Answer which we are getting for subtraction is called difference. What is the sixth question answer? Difference. Next, to find the missing minuend, the dash is added to the difference. Seventh question, listen. To find the missing minuend. Minuend means what? The second number. When you are doing subtraction, you will do the minuend. Okay, wait, listen. 724 minus 124. Okay. Actually, we are going to subtract these two numbers. How we will write? 724, 124. Like this only you will subtract, right? So, these two numbers which we are subtracting is called what? Subtrahends. That we have discussed already. Okay. But answer you will get no. 4 minus 4, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. 7 minus 1, 6. Answer which we are getting is called what? Difference. Okay. So listen. The second number is which is subtracted from the first number. No. This number is called as minuend. Okay, listen, two numbers are there which we are going to subtract it. That two numbers is called subtrahends. The second number which is subtracted from the first number, no, this number is called as minuend. And the answer which we are getting is difference. So, if you want to get this minuend, what you will do? You just subtract from this subtrahends. You can subtract these two values, you can get the minuend. So that is what the answer which we are getting. Okay, if you want to get this minuend, what you will do? You can do the operations from the subtrahends. What is the seventh question answer then? You have to get from the subtrahends. Subtrahends is your answer. Understood? Next is your 8th question. To find the missing subtrahend, the difference is subtracted from what? So totally subtrahend is there, minuend is there, difference is there. What you are going to find? Missing subtrahend. So difference is subtracted from what? From minuend. So 8th answer is minuend. Okay. Listen carefully. In this subtraction, we will have subtrahend, minuend and different. Okay. If they gave you subtrahend and different, you should find minuend. If they gave minuend and different, you should find subtrahend. Like this you should think it. So 8th one answer is minuend. 9th one, the difference of a given number and a zero is called given number. Okay. So already I told you, difference of a, if 4 minus 0 is what? 4. Because if I subtract any number with 0, you will get the same number. So answer is number itself. 9th question answer is number itself. You can write it, number itself, N-U-M-B-E-R, number itself. 9th question is what? Difference of a given number and zero. Given number, or number and a zero, if you are subtracting, you will get the same number. So that number is called as answer. 10th question. Difference of a given number and 1 is called dash of a number. Already we have found this type of problem. Difference of a given number. If you subtract 1 from that number, what you will write? It is a predecessor. Do you remember? If you add 1 to that number, what you will get? You will get successor. If you want to get predecessor, what you will do? You will subtract 1 to that number. So, difference of a given number and 1. We are subtracting a number and 1. What you will get? You will get the predecessor of a number. You can write 10th answer is predecessor. What is the spelling for predecessor? P-R-E-D-E-C-E-S-S-O-R. P-R-E-D-E-C-E-S-S-O-R. 11th question. When 1 is added to a number, if you add 1 to that number, you will get successor. Up 11th question answer is successor. If difference 1 means predecessor, plus 1 means successor. 11th question answer is successor. S-U-C-C-E-S-S-O-R. S-U-C-C-E-S-S-O-R. Okay, next. 12th question. When 0 is added to a given number, the sum is number itself. 4 plus 0, 4. So if I add a number with 0, you will get the same number. So 12th question answer is number. So shall I say all the answers of every question? First one, sum. Second one, vertical columns, place value chart. Third one, addends. Fourth one, subtrahends. Fifth one, minuends. Sixth one, difference. Seven, subtrahend. Eight, minuend. Nine, number. 10, predecessor. 11, successor. 12, number. Okay, I hope you all written. Okay. Today's class, we have discussed that get, set, go problems from page number 29. I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.